off that shit.
What happened to the original
plan? You're probably gonna have to come up here.
Okay.
You're gonna have to make the walk. I'm sorry. There's no way I'm gonna hear you over Whitewater and Eddie.
What happened to the original plans that were like in 2020 about a gravity group?
Oh. He's asking about the original plans in 2020 about a gravity group. So the real easy answer there is COVID. I mean, COVID sidelined a lot of projects and Cedar Fair was. They had a decision to make, Six Flags made their decision too, but they wanted to keep the staff on. They wanted to keep our full-time staff and not do layoffs and make a commitment to the people who make this park so great while we're operating. And they did that for all 13 parks across the country. So shout out to Cedar Fair. They just decided to show a lot of projects and to invest in the people. A lot of us, I wasn't here at the time, but a lot of us are our administrators were sent to Cedar Point to paint, sent out to Knott's Berry Farm to help work when they were open, sent down to Schlitterbahn to help those parks operate. So they found a creative way to keep us all on. Obviously that costs money when you're not making money as a park to keep people on and still pay them. But super shout out to them. The gravity group project itself, what happened, so obviously the sideline, your permits expire, you only have so long to do it. With COVID, there was a lot of uncertainty, so they made a decision not to move forward with the project. And then I think when they revisited and they said, what do we want to build here? Zambezi Zinger is obviously a wonderful role for us to just keep it as simple as possible. And there's a more complex explanation for that. But they specifically were looking to find something in our region that would be different and unique. Some changes at the top and some changes in leadership here at the park. I think that they decided that they wanted to go in a different direction from something that was wood to something that was steel. They wanted to go with the manufacturers that were trusted, and I think ultimately that's, I think once you know what we're putting in, I think it will kind of make sense why we changed course, but certainly when we revisited it again, once we came out of COVID, it was on the line. We just decided to go in a different direction. Some of that was change in leadership, some of that was market dynamics. Some of that is in the company that they felt that we needed to go in a different direction. So a lot of answers. Ultimately, the real answer is COVID has changed everything. So, for us. Yes, sir.